kindness, and in God's spirit, which is love and kindness. We welcome all visitors today, a couple, so welcome to you especially. And Mickey made it. Oh, yes. And Mickey has moved back into the neighborhood, in case you didn't know. So we're just glad, we're delighted to have you back in the neighborhood, Mickey. And Arnie showed up. Arnold showed up at church this last week, and he's up and around, and he's feeling good. So that's the real answer to prayer. Again, welcome. Please rise with me if you're able. We remember our baptism.
Thank you.
Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Thank you. Then the Lord said, How great is the outcry against Sodom and Gomorrah, and how very grave their sin. I must go down and see whether they have done altogether according to the outcry that has come to me. And if not, I will know. So the men turned from there and went towards Sodom, while Abraham remained standing before the Lord. Then Abraham came near and said, Will you indeed sweep away the righteous with the wicked? Suppose there are 50 righteous within the city. Will you then sweep away the place and not forgive it for the 50 righteous who are in it? Far be it from you to do such a thing, to slay the righteous with the wicked, so that the righteous fare as the wicked. Far be that from you. Shall not the judge of all the earth do what is just? And the Lord said, If I find at Sodom 50 righteous in the city, I will forgive the whole place for their sake. Abraham answered, Let me take it upon myself to speak to the Lord. I am but dust and ashes. Suppose 5 of the 50 are lacking. Will you destroy the whole city for lack of 5? And he said, I will not destroy it if I find 45 there. Again he spoke to him, Suppose 40 are found there. He answered, For the sake of 40, I will not do it. Then he said, Oh, do not let the Lord be angry if I speak. Suppose 30 are found there. He answered, I will not do it if I find 30 there. He said, Let me take it upon myself to speak to the Lord. Suppose 20 are found there. He answered, For the sake of 20 I will not destroy it. Then he said, Oh, do not let the Lord be angry if I speak just once more. Suppose 10 are found there. He answered, For the sake of 10 I will not destroy it. The word of the Lord.
Spirits of the universe and not according to Christ. For in him the
and you have come to fullness in Him who is the head of every ruler and authority. In Him also you were circumcised with a spiritual circumcision by putting off the body of the flesh in the circumcision of Christ. When you were buried with Him in baptism, you were also raised with Him through faith in the power of God who raised Him from the dead. The word of the Lord.
Childish thinking.
Much of the thinking around God and around prayer, I think, is quite childish. People think of God in rather wooden terms. God's up there, God is watching. God's watching over here, but not so much over here. God's with these people, but not with these people. God's more in this kind of church than in that kind of church. God favors some people more than other people. God can be bargained with. God will heal me if I just pray hard enough, if I believe enough. God loves me if I'm good, not so much if I'm not so good. These are childish ways of thinking. And they're warned against in the very first commandment that was given to Moses on Sinai. You shall make no image of me. And that's precisely what we do. We make God in our own image, only bigger.
As we sang, God of every nation.
Jesus spoke in images and metaphors. God is like, the kingdom of God is like. Jesus seemed to use the word like more than a teenager nowadays. God is like. God is like this, God is like that. God is like a widow who lost a coin and turned her house upside down until she found it. So it is with everyone who is lost in the world. God cares that much. God is like an unjust judge. God is like a cranky neighbor who doesn't want to get up and help a friend. God is like, God is like, God is like. Our Father, he said. God is like our Father. God is like our Father. God is not a Father. God is like a Father. Like a loving Father, like a caring Father, like a present Father. Or Mother. Or Mother Hen. With chicks. God is like, God is like, God is like. Every nation, all people. Spirit to those who ask. Let us pray for the Holy Spirit in us, among us, in our world. Let us pray for the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of the divine presence, the Spirit of love that created the universe, every farthest galaxy, the love that sustains all life, and the love to which we return.
Thank you.
Gracious God, we simply offer back to you and to the world the things that you first gave us in the first place. Ourselves, our time, our possessions, signs of your gracious love. Receive them and use them for the grace toward all. Amen.
words in danger.
And yet after supper he took the cup, he gave thanks and gave it to everyone present to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The table is prepared, and the fruit is welcome.
Mercy upon us, have mercy.
Gracious God, we thank you for feeding us body, mind, and spirit, for giving us daily bread, which is also spiritual nourishment. And we pray, hallowed be your name. We remember the awesome gift of life, from beginning to end, from all that we have and all that surrounds us, by which we live. And the miracle of life itself, for which we are grateful. Thank you. Go in peace, serve the Lord.
Thank you.